Morning, everyone. How are we doing?
Good.
Good. Glad to hear it. All righty. This season, we've hired some new workers. A couple of them haven't worked in agriculture before. In fact, this may be their first job. With that being said, we've updated our new hire policy to include information about young workers and workers with limited experience. You'll get a copy of that later. So, let's talk about that. First things first, as supervisor, you are responsible for training the new workers. It is very important that we keep up with regular training.
What do you mean by regular training?
Here in the policy, it states that young workers need training not only at the time they're hired, but continuously. For example, training should occur every time you assign a new task, and a refresher training every time you switch a task. We need to make sure that we have additional training after injuries or close calls to prevent future incidents. We should also check in periodically to review policies and procedures to make sure they're being used. I need to be sure that we're all on the same page here. Understanding this topic is crucial to your role as a supervisor. Can anyone give me a scenario where you might be unsure when additional training is needed?
What if we switch equipment on the job and there's a new employee that claims to know how to use it, but I've never seen them use it before?
Great scenario. Even if the worker claims to know the equipment, it is your responsibility as a supervisor to ensure that there are no avoidable risks in the job. So, training needs to take place through you demonstrating proper use, and then make sure that the worker can explain it back to you. Then, have them demonstrate proper use of the equipment. This is the only way to ensure the safety of our workers. What other questions, everyone? Speaking of training, let's move on to the next topic. Training sessions should be detailed and only focus on one task at a time. Most of us only remember about 20% of what we learn. So in addition to the training, we need to make sure that we are supervising these workers.
Are there different types of supervision?
Well, yes, there are three types. The first type is constant supervision, when the worker is within sight and sound of the supervisor. This would occur with a new worker who has never done the task before. Second is intermittent supervision. In this case, the worker is out of sight and sound for a short period of time, and the supervisor is checking in on them every 15 minutes. This is when they've done it before, but not very often. Third is periodic supervision. In this case, the worker is out of sight and sound for 15 to 30 minutes. This type of supervision should only occur when the worker has done the task several times and are following the correct steps. In addition to supervising new workers, we want to check in with everyone at the start of the day when we assign tasks. Make sure you are using open-ended questions and not yes or no questions to make sure that the worker understands the task and how to do it. A lot of times, new workers, especially the younger ones, are self-conscious about speaking up, and they want to act like they know what they're doing. So, they may not want to tell you if they don't understand something.
Could you give me an example of an open-ending question?
Sure. Instead of asking, "Can you do this?" ask them, "Could you show me how to do this?" This allows them to explain the task instead of giving them the opportunity to nod and walk away. What other questions or thoughts do we have?
I think it might be a good idea if next week we talk about how this worked.
Yes, absolutely. What other questions, everyone? All right, great meeting. Let's get to work.